गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव डन विद योर होमवर्क। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड। बट वॉट डू वी मीन बाय कॉम्पोनेंट्स? इट मीन्स पार्ट्स। सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ आर फूड। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई से यू आर गोइंग टू हैव दाल, राइस एंड सैलड इन योर लंच, आर दे ऑल सेम और दे कंटेन सेम न्यूट्रिएंट? Before starting that, we should know what is nutrient. Here, the ingredients of our food contain some components. Okay, those components are called nutrients. In simple words, the components of food which are needed by our body are called nutrients. Now, most of you are thinking why we need them. Actually, our food contain various kind of nutrients and each of them is specialized to perform a specific function. These major nutrients are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. And in addition to them, we also take water and dietary fibers. Okay, so they are giving you some tests here. These tests will check the presence of a particular component in our food item, in a given food item. For example, test for starch. Take a small quantity of food item or a raw ingredient. Put 2 to 3 drops of dilute iodine solution on it and you will observe a blue black color which will indicate the presence of starch. We will perform this test on the slice of potato, as potato is a carbohydrate rich food. So we'll take that slice, we'll put 2 to 3 drop of iodine solution on it and you will see immediately the color will change to blue black. That shows the presence of starch in your potato slice. Yes, test for protein. Take a small quantity of a food item. If the food is solid, then you are supposed to crush it or make it into a paste. Grind or mash a small quantity of that food item. Put 10 to 12 drops of water in it. Now shake well. Now using a dropper, add 2 drops of solution of copper sulfate, that is CuSO4, and 10 drops of caustic soda to the test tube. Now shake well and you are supposed to leave it for few minutes. After few minutes, you will observe a violet color will appear. If it appears, that means your food item contains protein. If not, that means no protein is present in that given food item. And the third test is for fats. And it is very simple. Take small quantity of food item, wrap it in a piece of paper and crush it. When you open the paper, you will see a oily patch. Actually, that oily patch on paper shows that food item contains fat. We have some sources here in the figure 2.3. These are the sources of carbohydrates: bajra, rice, wheat, sweet potato, sugarcane, papaya, melon, mango, maize. These all are carbohydrate rich source of food. On the other hand, we have in 2.4 some sources of fats like sunflower oil, mustard oil, coconut oil, soybean oil, your groundnuts, nuts, fish, meat, eggs. They contain small quantity of fat, whether from the plant sources or from the animal sources. Now let us study what do various nutrients do for our body. As told earlier, these components of food are specialized, or nutrients are specialized to perform a particular function. Carbohydrate and fat provide us energy, thus they are called energy yielding food. But you will be amazed by knowing that fat gives double the energy given by the same quantity of carbohydrate. Yes, the food which contain proteins are called bodybuilding foods. Why? As you know, our nails, hair, skin, everything contain protein. That means the protein is making our body parts, right? So protein here is called bodybuilding food. Vitamin help in protecting our body against diseases. You have studied carbohydrate, fat and protein. They all are nutritious. But here you will study vitamins and minerals. They are not at all nutritious, but they are required for proper functioning of our body. Thus, they are called protective food. Vitamins are of different kind. So, they are named by different names like vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E and K. And we have vitamin B complex. Here, the term complex means vitamin B is not only one. It's a group of vitamin B, like vitamin B1, B4, B6, B9, B12, etc. Our body needs all these vitamins, but in very small quantity. As I told you, they are not nutritious. They are required for only proper functioning of our body. For example, let us take example from your school. We have so many teachers, but principal is only one who will guide. In a similar way, we need lots of carbohydrate, fat, protein, but vitamin and mineral is required in small quantities. Yes, vitamin A, for example, vitamin A keeps our skin and eyes healthy. Vitamin C helps our body to fight against many diseases. Thus, we can say vitamin C provides immunity. Vitamin D helps our body to use calcium for bones and teeth. Here they mean if we have a good quantity of vitamin D in our body, whatever food we are having, if it contains vitamin D, if it contains calcium, that calcium will be fully utilized by our body. Yes, now minerals. Minerals are needed by our body in small amounts. They are essential for the protection and the proper growth. Here, most food item you will see contain more than one nutrient. It is possible that one nutrient is present in high content. On the other hand, that other nutrient will present in small quantity, but it may contain more than one nutrient. For example, your milk contains fat, carbohydrate, protein, vitamin and minerals, but it's only one food item. In a similar way, your rice may contain minerals and vitamins, but it contains carbohydrates in very high quantity. Thus, we can say your rice is carbohydrate rich source of food. Okay, here besides these nutrients, our body needs dietary fibers and water. Dietary fibers are also known as roughage, and that roughage is mainly provided by plant products in our food. For example, whole grain, pulses, potatoes, fresh fruits, vegetables, these are main source of roughage. As roughage do not provide any nutrient to our body, but still it is very essential component of our food, as it adds bulk to our food. Bulk means heaviness. If we have a small quantity of roughage containing food, we will feel that we are full, we are done with the food. That means it provides bulk. As it is not nutritious and it provides bulk, we will eat less nutrients. So it will also help our digestive system to feel light. So we can say that roughage, as it cannot be digested by our body, it will come as it is outside of the body. So it will clean our intestine as well. Thus, it boosts our digestive system. Water helps our body to absorb nutrients from food. As you know, our body is approximately 70% water. So it is very important component of our food. Almost all fruits and vegetables have small quantity of water to large quantity of water. If I'll give you the example of apricot, it also contains very less quantity of water. But if I'll talk about watermelon, it contains very high quantity of water. That means almost all fruits, vegetables contain water, though the amount is different. It also helps us to throw the body waste outside. For example, it will help to clean our body in form of urine or sweating. Yes, now balanced diet. As the term is balanced, that means we are creating a balance here. Diet means whatever food we are taking is called our diet. Like you are going to have that dal, rice and salad in your lunch, that is also a diet. Okay. Yes, let me tell you, your dal is made with pulses. That means it is protein rich food. Then your rice is carbohydrate rich food. And your salad, that is raw vegetables, are good source of minerals and vitamins. So you are having various components in your lunch. Here, balanced diet deals with the same. Balanced means when we know what quantity of a particular nutrient is required by our body, and we take a diet in accordance to that only, that will be called balanced diet. It is good, it is required for good growth and maintenance of good health. A diet should have all the nutrients in a particular amount, in a required amount. So the diet should also contain a good amount of roughage and water, and such a diet which contain all the components, whether it is carbohydrate, protein, vitamin and minerals, fats, your roughage and water in a proper amount, in a right quantity, that is called your balanced diet. Yes, here eating the right kind of food is not enough. We should also take care while cooking it. So let me tell you one thing, are some of the cooking habits leads to loss of many nutrients. For example, if the vegetables and fruits are washed after cutting or peeling them, it may result in the loss of some vitamins. On the other hand, if we peel the skin of many vegetables and fruit, that peels contain vitamins and minerals in them, so we lost them as well. In a similar way, if we wash rice and pulses repeatedly again and again, many of the nutrients like your vitamins and minerals are lost with that washing. Now it's cooking. When we cook food with either excess of water or with high temperature, some of the nutrients get lost. For example, if we cook food with lots of water in it, we will lose useful proteins and considerable amount of minerals. In a similar way, vitamin C gets easily destroyed by heat during cooking. Okay, now it can be very harmful for us to eat too much of fat-rich foods, and we may end up suffering from a condition called obesity. What is obesity? You have seen some of the persons are overweight. They are very bulky. Actually, the overweight and bulkiness of a person's body due to excessive accumulation of fat in it is called obesity. When a person eats too much of fat, that fat is not utilized properly, it starts accumulating in your body, which results in the over bulkiness or overweight of your body. That condition is called obesity. There are some causes. If we eat too much of fat rich food, or there is metabolic disorder. Metabolic disorder means डिसऑर्डर रिलेटेड टू आर डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम और बॉडी फंक्शनिंग, और वी आर टू लेजी, दैट मीन्स लैक ऑफ फिजिकल वर्क और एक्सरसाइज, दैट कंडीशन में कॉस्ट. इट्स इफेक्ट्स आर हाई फैट लेवल इन द ब्लड. एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट फैट इज नॉट प्रॉपरली यूटिलाइज, सो इट विल स्टार्ट एक्यूमुलेटिंग इन आर बॉडी, इट विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग इन आर ब्लड एज वेल. इट मे लीड्स टू हार्ट अटैक और डायबिटीज. ओके, यस. Now, deficiency diseases, as the term deficiency means lack or small quantity of a particular thing. So here, a person may be getting enough food. It is possible that person is having a good quantity of food daily, 3 times a day. But maybe he is having only same kind of food, which results in lack of a particular kind of nutrient. Thus, that nutrient deficiency may cause some kind of disorder in that person's body. So let us study deficiency disease. A person may be getting enough food to eat, but sometimes the food may not contain a particular nutrient. If this continues over a long period of time, the person may suffer from its deficiency. That deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause diseases or disorders in our body. Diseases that occur due to lack of nutrients over a long period of time are called deficiency diseases. So one may define deficiency disease as a disease caused by a lack of either one or more than one nutrient in our food for a long period of time. Okay, if a person does not get enough protein, I'm giving you example, if a person does not get enough proteins in his or her food for a long time, he or she is likely to have stunt growth, means the growth is not proper, there is swelling on face, the color of the hair will also get faded, skin diseases may occur, or that person may suffer diarrhea. In a similar way, if the person's diet do not contain carbohydrates and proteins for a long period of time, the growth may stop completely. Such a person becomes very lean, thin, and sometimes that person may become so weak that the person is not able to move even. Deficiency of different vitamins and minerals may also result in this certain disease or disorder, which we are going to study in this table, and you are supposed to make this table in your notebook. Here, vitamin and mineral are given. Vitamin A deficiency disease is loss of vision, means person may become blind. Its symptoms are poor vision or loss of vision in darkness. Okay, sometime if it is not cured, the person may become blind or completely lost vision. Yes, vitamin B1 causes beriberi. Beriberi have some symptoms like weak muscles, and we always feel tired. We have very little energy to do anything. Yes, vitamin C leads to scurvy. That means a condition in which our gums become too weak, starts bleeding. And if you have any wound on skin, it may take extra time to heal up. Vitamin D causes rickets. It's a condition when your bones become too soft that they are not able to bear your weight properly and starts bending. Calcium, it is a mineral. It may cause disease related to bone and teeth. That means bone and tooth decay, and its symptoms are related to that only. That means weakness of bone and tooth. Yes, iodine leads to goiter. Actually, we have some glands, thyroid gland in our neck region, and if there is any deficiency of iodine in our body, that glands start swelling. It also results in mental disability in children. Iron leads to anemia, and anemia have symptom of weakness. Why we have weakness? Actually, anemia is the condition in which we have very less number of RBC or red blood cell in us, and that red blood cells are responsible for carrying oxygen. In turn, they are taking carbon dioxide as waste from the cells and return it to the lungs, right? So if we do not have a good quantity of oxygen in our body, we start feeling weak. So these are some of the deficiency diseases or disorder caused by vitamin and mineral. Okay, yes, kindly go through the chapter once, and still if there is any doubt, you can ask. Its exercise or written part I'll give you in the next lecture, that is on Friday. Thank you.